Hey guys, this is episode 5 of Minecraft Down Under. What are we going to be doing today? Well, we're actually going to be starting the skeleton, the skeleton structure of the main base. See, we're currently living inside of the side of a hill, and this is called a hobbit hole, just somewhere where we're safe and we can gather resources and get established. That's pretty much the key goal of a hobbit hole, but this is definitely not going to be the permanent base of for me. No way. We're planning on putting a decent sized base out here. These plains is going to be perfect. Before we get started, actually, I'm going to go ahead and breed those rabbits again. I'm trying my very best to keep them bred and stocked up. So I'm going to go ahead and just dump all this garbage out. Actually, take that with me. So I've been doing a lot of mining and a lot of farming in the nether right now, because I've chosen the two colors for the new base, which is going to be stone brick and nether brick as well. And yes, they're growing up, so let's kill these guys first. Oh, they sound so cute. I'm so mean. All right, kill them first. But yeah, every chance I get when I come out here, I always keep these guys killed. And because I've already eaten the 30 odd cooked rabbits I had before, because I've been mining like crazy, getting enchants and all sorts of stuff. But so we gotta keep these guys up. So we still gotta find some chooks. I'm really, really interested in finding some chooks to bring home and start an actual chook farm, because I'd prefer cooked chicken rather than rabbit any day. Yeah, because I want to get something a little automated, you know, set up. So, got to do that soon. We just got to go find some, I suppose. All right, you guys are done? Yes, they're done. Go ahead and press that button. They're all going to make babies. You guys done? Yep. Fantastic. Yeah, I think they're done. All right, good stuff. Let's get them out. Get the babies out. Fantastic. All right, we'll let them grow up, put the carrots back, because I've got to remember, stop eating the carrots. Sometimes when I have the carrots selected, I accidentally eat them. as I said, I'm quite out of cooked rabbit at the moment, so I've been doing the baked potato diet at the moment. Okie dokie. So I'm going to go grab some scaffolding, and we're going to pillar up and have a look around and start really taking a look at that plains area there where we're going to be building the new castle. So as I was saying, I've been doing a metric butt ton of mining, and I've been mining netherrack to get the nether brick, because we gotta get all that up and going. And I've been smelting them over to stone bricks, and the nether brick is in here. I've been melting those over as well. So, you know, I've just been crazy doing a metric butt ton of work right now, and this is actually almost done, so we might wait a few seconds before going out there. I really come in here for cobblestone scaffolding, so we can pillar up and get a really good bird's eye of the area. So pretty much every drop of coal I'm getting, it's been going into these furnaces to keep the maximum. All I've been doing is trying to keep the coal to these furnaces up the top, you know, max. So yeah, and as you can see, that I'm already used half a stack in these bad boys already. Should get some sort of industrial furnace set up. That would make things so much more easier. Could transfer these into some bricks. So yeah, we'll be definitely using nether brick, and we're using regular stone brick as well together in this build. Now it's gonna blend pretty nicely when it comes to Datacraft, but I'm not sure about the default textures or any other texture packs, but we will see. I've got ideas. I cannot wait to start this. It's gonna be one hell of a base, I'll tell you that. It's gonna require a metric butt ton of resources to get done. Alrighty. So let's put those in there, and the bricks in the bottom. Alright. We'll go ahead and throw some more rack on. Just making sure I'm keeping all this up, because once we start building, resources will be flying out the window, but not coming in as quick. So I'm just going to keep these guys burning 24/7 until I run out of coal, which will be soon. And then we're going to have to do way more mining. All right. Okay, so that is all done. Fantastic. All right. Okay, so let's go out and do some planning now. Got the cobblestone I was after before. Where's that sun at? Oh, looks like it's well into the afternoon. That is okay. We will just be careful. If the sun goes down, we'll just race home and sleep. All right. So, okay, this base is going to be quite large. Now, as you can see, the environment here, the plains, is all wonky. Now, the original plan was to actually fill all this in and bring it up. Like, bring it up quite a lot. Like, about 6 blocks all the way around. In, like, I would say 70 by 70 square, at least, just filling all this in. Now, that is a ridiculous amount of work. And I don't think it's worth it. To save time, I believe the best way to do it is see how flat all this is. I believe just taking all this out with the shovel here, taking it all back and building down here, this flat, and filling these little chunks in and ponds and stuff in, I think that's probably the best way to do it, to be honest. See, look how most of this is flat and fantastic. But yeah, just carve out some of these mountains here. I think that would be better than filling it in, because then if we wouldn't have to find the resources to fill it in, because the amount of dirt that it would actually require to do this job, it would take a metric butt ton of dirt just to fill it in. And before we scaffold up, I'm going to actually run inside and quickly sleep in the bed, because it would be extremely bad if we have a bunch of nasties. Actually, level 30, we need to do some enchanting. I know I should have closed the door, but hopefully I'll be able to sleep before anything decides to wander on in. And we have... Okay. Alright, so let's get a nice bird's eye view. I've roughly told you my plan. We're going to carve it all out instead of fill it all in. So it's sort of a reverse of what I was thinking in the first place. So if we can get a nice bird's eye view here, we might be able to get a little bit more planning in. So just scaffold right up. Do this whole nerd pole sort of thing. Alright, see what I mean? It's just so flat in here. If we just take some of these little hills out here and flatten them down, I think it would go well. The only problem, the only concerning area would be this section here, because that's actually, most of that wouldn't be dirt, because it's actually quite a large hill, and most of it will be stone, so we would have to end up taking that out. That's completely fine, but as I said, all the dirt that we carve out, we fill in these weird holes here. The only thing we have to watch for is there's a ravine there going under the ground, so, you know, I think it's a decent way. I haven't explored it yet. I should have done that, because guarantee there's probably a decent amount of iron sitting in the ravine walls in there that I've got to take out. But yeah, that goes under the ground here, so wow, if we're digging down, we have to watch out. We will fall to the death. That would be completely bad. Okay, so what we need to do, I think that's enough planning. Let's put up the rough front skeleton of the base, and we can talk a little bit more about what we're gonna do. Oh, this will be the first big structure on this map. I plan to do some big farms, but this would be technically the first major structure we're starting. Now, don't get me wrong, it's not going to come up overnight. It's going to take weeks. We're going to work on it occasionally. We might do other things, other episodes, but we'll work on it occasionally and work on it live streams and all sorts of stuff. So, yeah, as you can see, I've been stockpiling enchanted picks here because the new enchanting system in 1.8 is pretty cool. So, yeah, I've been stockpiling enchanting and not doing too bad with the resource side here at the moment. So it's not bad actually at all. Okay, so we're going to grab. We won't grab too many. Alright, that will do. A couple more of those bad boys. And then some nether brick, which we don't need straight off the bat. But we'll grab it anyway. Alright, that will do. Alright, let's go out and find out where, technically, the front is going to be facing. Well, there is actually going to be no front to this base. There's going to be no front. It's going to be all sides, technically, at the front. So, if we're going to technically bring it down this low, this is where we need to put the front entrance, around here somewhere. Yep. We need to put it around here somewhere. And we can either put it a bit this way. Hello, bunny. Gonna kill you for your meat. Come back here. Yeah. There, got him. Okay, so get back on the task at hand here. So I'm thinking right here, we might have to take this back a bit, to be honest. I don't want to go too far back because, you know, I want the ocean closest. Yeah, okay, we're just going to start right here. I think this is perfect for what we need. Right here will be absolutely perfect. Okay. All right, here we go. All right, so the idea in my head, let me explain this. The idea is going to be combining two of my builds here. So a long time ago, I built a slime farm pretty much out of a wood structure. It turned out really beautiful, and I always thought that that sort of structure would be amazing to build a base out, like a base roughly shaped like that. So I'm going to use the base structure there, but just the wings, as I'm calling them the wings. So just the wings in the middle, we're going to, somewhere in the middle down there is going to be like a sort of towers with rooms and stuff in them. It's really hard to explain what's in my head. It's going to come up slowly. Over time, it's going to come up slowly. So let's go ahead and we'll just start, I suppose. Okay, so I would say 10 up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, 10 up. Yeah, wall. This is huge. Alright, so what we'll do is use that. We'll come up by another 2. And then we're going to go over by 5. So we're making an arch. That's what we're currently doing, is making an arch. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, whoa, I nearly jumped off then, you Fruit Loop data, 5, okay, so once we've gone up by 5, then we're going to start going over by, I think we'll go over by, I'd say, 4, so we're slowly stepping it up, because we want that arch feel, yeah, we want that arch feel, so we're going up, we come up by 5, and then we're going over by 2, then up, and then over by another 2, and I think to match that, to be all nice, we'll do 10. So there's 10 on the sides, and there'll be 10 in the center here as well. Wow, this is large. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Holy smokes, this structure is just going to be huge. It's going to be a monster. It's going to be cool. All right. So what we need to do, wow, is go down now somehow. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to scaffold up. So we're going to go to the lowest point here, and we're going to get ourselves down without killing ourselves. Ow. Oh, wow. I think I might be going a little bit large here, especially. This is huge. Okay, let's go ahead and scaffold up. So I wish I brought some cobblestone. I'd rather use something less important, and since this stone brick is quite kind of important right now, yeah. Okay, so what we're gonna do, same thing, we're gonna replicate that on the side there, but we're going opposite now. So 1, 2, 1, 2, and then I think we just need to drop down now. Yeah, so that's 1. So we're gonna go drop down. So I have big plans for my new storage system. I have big plans for the central towers and a library. Oh, do I have plans? So that's 3. That's 4. Let's go down a little bit. Yeah. So remind me, I've got to pick up these stone bricks. They're so important right now. And 5. Yep, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think we did 5 on the other side, did we? Not quite sure. Not 100% sure, anyway. But we can start getting rid of these grooves, as I would call them. Crikey. Because we just want the arch for now. The red brick is going to be for window seals. We're going to make the window seals out of red brick. Okay, so what we're going to do now, since that's 5, we can go ahead and take it down. Take it down by 2? Did I? Oh, I think I did. No, because then... Oh, no, because I tried to... Yeah, all right. I'm confusing myself now, which is not a great idea. All right, down we go. Gonna double check that. I'm pretty sure the top was a 2, but the sides were a 1. Yeah, top was a 2 there. Don't count the red brick, by the way. And the side was a 1, yeah. Okay. Just not trying not to confuse myself. Alright, so what we'll do... Scaffold right up again. We high enough? Nope. So a 2. And then, we just take this down to the ground. That should be a 10. It should be. I'm not 100% sure. Make sure all that's pretty much lined up with each other. There we go. Holy smokes, guys. This is going to look like a hall, how big this is. Holy smokes. Okay, so, yeah. So what's actually going to happen now is... So this will come back, I would say, about 30 blocks. So it would come back around here. Yeah, not that's about 30 blocks. So it'd come back around here, and then right here, roughly, will be a tower. So like a big round tower, huge, about 5-6 wide. And just this is rough markings. This ain't round. You could see that, crikey. So round tower here, and then we sort of go out. Holy smoke! So that means we got to carve out all this. And we put another one of those over there and come back. So 4 towers will be in each corner here, going up by 50 blocks. And then it's sort of going to be a castle sort of shape in the middle here. Yeah, castle shape in the middle with these grand hallway looking things going onto the outside. Oh, it's really hard to explain. I do apologize. It's hard to explain what's in my head and how this is going to be laid out. It's just difficult. It will take shape over time, and I just want to stress that to you guys. You know, it's going to take shape over time, and it will look pathetic at first, but at once it starts to come up, it will start coming together, and then people will be like, whoa. So, yeah. You guys know my color scheme already, which is red nether brick and just normal brick. The windows, also, we're not going for traditional windows. No, we're going to try something a little different. We might go for light blue or blue windows, because as some of my subscribers do actually know, blue is my favorite color, and I'm going to try incorporate it into this build as well. But yeah, we'll be looking up eventually. There'll be these 4 towers up there, and oh, guys, I cannot wait until this is done. All right. Okay, so back at it. What I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to go ahead and remove that. Actually, I'm going to get some proper scaffolding, and then I'm going to remove those red bricks around that arch there, and then we're going to continue. Alrighty then, guys. I am back, and as you can see, I've put up quite a bit here. All I did is widened that arch. As you can see, I've gone 3 wide now, and I filled it in. So, and I've started cutting out some of the, I had to cut out this mountain here because it was like, oh, it was half in this entranceway here. And yeah, so that is what I am currently up to. And we can go ahead and put the dirt blocks that I got from here. As I said, it's going to fill in some of the surrounding holes, which is going to be good. So we're going to keep all the dirt we possibly can. But for now, we'll keep it on us. Probably get a chest out here and put some torches up at some... Actually, let's put some torches out the front here for now. So, I know we can't still work at night time. It's nowhere near... There's nowhere to hide if there's a zombie apocalypse, if you know what I'm saying. Okay, so, obviously, this is just way, way too much stone brick. You know, it's at the end of the day, it's gonna be... This is just a skeleton, looks ugly, and yeah... So I'm pointing that out now, but what we're going to go ahead and do is start actually wrapping it with the nether brick and putting the windows in. But first of all, I think we're going to do the corners, then we're going to find the center here, because there's going to be a piston door somewhere in the center, and 2 long windows on both sides, and we'll make them 3D, and we'll make them sort of pop out to give it the effect that I'm after. But what I want to do is actually wrap the farm here. So what I want to do is sort of like this to start giving it some color. Now, I've never actually built too many things out of this nether brick before, so that's why I thought to myself, well, hey, it's going to be now. So, yeah, I know some people don't actually like this stuff, but I don't know. It's going to match this build quite nicely. So what I want to do is, like, we're going to be wrapping the farm like that and making it thicker. So we're giving it a more, instead of so flat, it's going to be more of a 3D feel. See, we're already making it thicker on the side. See what I'm trying to say? All right, so let's go ahead and wrap the entire thing and just see what it looks like. Going to use dirt as scaffolding so we can get up and down easily without wasting precious resources. We're just going to wrap the whole thing. I should have left the nether brick there before because I just took some out. Crikey, I'm just putting it back. You Fruit Loop data. I would kill for a shovel of doom to remove half this mountain would be lovely. I'm going to have to work on that next, I think. Do some more mining, rack up some XP and just go crazy and make some shovels of dooms. Yes, I don't have an XP farm, but it's not necessary at the moment, actually. I'm actually getting enough XP from mining and killing rabbits and nasties. It's quite good. Oh, do I have to go higher? No, I don't. All right, just be careful. All right. Keep making the scaffolding wider, and we'll start from the end here and work our way back. So we're going to do the same probably for the other side. Let's keep going. So hopefully, I'm thinking, I don't know, well, is that sun going down? Crikey. Let's just try get this side done before we run inside and sleep. Yeah, we're gonna try get the base done hopefully before we get into the high teens. That's my goal anyway when it comes to episode wise. As I said, we won't be working on the base every single episode because it's gonna take quite a long time to construct this monster of a base here. So, all right, let's go ahead and get rid of this. The moon's coming up and we're gonna see nasties come out and oh crikey. Alright, let's go ahead and get down from here. I'm just packing this up. Yikes. All I'm worried about is probably an Enderman. They do a metric butt ton of damage. I'm not in enchanted gear, I'm in iron gear. So, yeah. Let's, come on, I don't want to go sleep yet. I just bring the bed out here. That'd be much easier. And done. Ha! Let's get out of here. Right now, before something nasty happens. And we'll make some stairs too, because I've got to show you the rough idea of the window seals that I'm thinking of to make it sort of pop out. Alright, run, go, 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 go! Quick! Whoa! Right in front of me, crikey. Nothing's coming up behind me. Hello? No, don't, not there! Just stop, don't put holes in me, new map. Gotcha. Haha. Alright. Whew. Crikey. Okay, so we'll sleep, then we'll get some stairs, we'll make some nether brick stairs, that's what I need next. So, whoa, actually, let's make a chest. Do I have... Oh, yes, I do. Make another chest, put on top fire out. Put all the dirt away, because we're going to need that for later. Flowers and all sorts of good stuff. Alright, let's make some stairs now. There we go. We'll go with about 2 stacks for now. There we go, 2 stacks. Get some more stairs out. More nether brick out, which far out, we're running low already. Holy smokes. This thing is going to take for ages. Oh, crikey, yeah. Just the one wall, data. Just one wall. Whoa. Did I just hear a nasty? It just sounded like I heard a nasty. Just one wall is up right now. That's ridiculous. Crikey. Holy smokes. Oh, I missed one block. Whoa. I missed one block. We'll fix that up. We will fix that up. All right. Okay, let's talk windows. This thing's going to have windows, so we need to leave a gap. We're going to take our nether brick stairs here, and what we're actually going to do is we're going to give it a pop-out feel. So we've got to come out by a couple. How many wide do you think? 2? 2 seems a bit thin, to be honest with you. Let's go 3. Let's go 3. Whoop. Let's come out there. What we'll do is fill this in here. No. We've got to come out further than that, to be honest. Because I really, what I want to do is put like a pillar effect here. See, going up the wall like this. So it's going to give it more of a 3D in-depth feel. So, crikey. But we've got to watch out as well. Because how many of these can I fit in? Because I'm going to put two in and then a door here. And what I really want to do with this top is put my Daedalus diamond logo in the top here. So that's the whole idea. But now I'm trying to think if it's all going to fit in. Do I have to move it over a couple? Do, you know, what sort of thing's going to go on there? So, yeah, trying to plan ahead as well. You know, you don't want to stuff up so badly you have to rip stuff down. Because it's happened to me before. It has actually happened to me before. See, that only makes it too wide. So let's bring it back one here. Yeah, so I don't want to stuff up too badly because then whole structures have to come down. And I don't want to connect this. I want to leave a gap. I always want to leave a gap. We're not going any shorter than that. But I'm trying to, yeah, keep the space low. And I don't even know how high to take these windows up. So we'll just guesstimate and we'll adjust later on the fly. Like that. See? Oh, yes. So, okay. So the same thing on the opposite side. This would be the inside. This would be the inside right here. So the same thing on the inside to match the outside to give it the 3D look. Now, I've got an idea, but we don't have any at the moment. So I'll explain in a second the idea I have. Once we get the coloured glass up and going as well, should be quite nice. Smokes. Go away. Okay, so what we're going to do, you see the guts of the window here, right? We're going to put glowstone in here, and then we're going to put coloured glass in there, so the whole window should literally glow at night time. It's going to look epic. Well, in my mind, it looks epic. So, we'll wait and see, Data, you Fruit Loop. Alright, so what I'm going to go ahead and do is get both of these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 seems like a good number. We might go one more. I'm going to make it 6. I'm going to make it 6 watt, because that's pretty getting bitty tall as it is, windows here. Holy smokes, I can't believe I'm talking about windows. But yeah, I want it to glow at night time. That's going to be a goal. Okay, so what we'll do is wrap the top in here with it as well, like that. And what we're going to do is take the upside down, we're going to take some upside down stairs here and literally go around it like that to give it even better look. So we come out the side here. There we go. Fantastic. Lovely. All right. And now we're talking. It's coming together quite nicely. And I'm using the wrong stuff for scaffolding again, you Fruit Loop. Oh, that needs to be changed. But yeah, she should come together nicely. Over time, it will come together quite nicely. Oh, crikey. I bet these windows are way too tall, because my diamond logo is not going to fit in the middle, I reckon. Probably way too tall, to be honest with you. Flat tops or rounded off? Flat tops or rounded off? That's the question. So, let's find out. So, we're going to leave it flat like this. Or we can round it off. Now, rounding it off, what do I mean about rounding it off? Like, put stairs facing the opposite way around like this. And that should give it a curve feel when you look at it. Like that. And you can either fill this in, probably put glowstone in here so it sort of, at nighttime, it radiates like upwards. I don't know. Sorry, I get carried away when I'm building nowadays in Minecraft. It just, so awesome building just giant structures like this. It's gonna be epic, and just gonna take some work. It's gonna take a lot of work. People don't realize these things do not go up overnight, especially in a new series. See what I mean? Curved. I like that curved look. I bloomin' like it. Absolutely love it. Okay, we should stop playing around with blooming windows and get back to what I was doing originally. I can't believe I got so sidetracked. I was originally wrapping the entire outside in red brick. And I got blooming sidetracked. Doesn't matter. Good stuff. Okay, let's scaffold up, get this rest of this wrapped in, and I think we'll call it an episode. We've got a bit done today. I think I might start clearing out some of this and marking more of it out in the for the future. Here, so what I want to do is wrap this whole thing. I'm trying just to get that in-depth 3D look here going. We can stand back and look at it here. So we probably ought to put some torches up here until we get some actual structural lighting up, because as you guys know, they're going to spawn on the roof, they're going to spawn everywhere. Out the bloomin' yazoo! Okay, alright, so what we'll do is use a cobblestone to get down off of here, because it's going to hurt. So what we'll do is do that. I wish I had dirt. Dirt's better. Dirt's better for what I'm just about to do. Dirt is better. I don't have any more dirt. Yelch! Okay. That's all good. How's it looking? Oh yeah, that's coming along nicely. Once we cut the middle out here, put a big diamond logo sort of in here with glowstone and colored glass, big door in here, probably make the door come out as well. Don't leave it flat. Well, we can't. Where are we going to put the redstone? I want piston doors. So that is going to be a challenge right there, guys. How are we going to hide the redstone into the walls of the structure when the walls of the structure is not actually that thick? So there we go. That's also going to be another challenge when we come to it, because we got no slime balls, so can't make sticky pistons right now. Crikey. I feel so poor. All right. Let's continue and get this entire thing wrapped, I think. Far out. Alrighty then, guys, I've gone ahead and wrapped the entire structure like I said I was going to do, just to make it feel thicker and more 3D, like it's got some support, because once we start carving out, you know, as I was saying before, the big diamond logo and putting all these windows in, all this stone brick will actually start to be thinned right out, and, you know, hopefully the sides feel like they're more supporting it out, and I'll start marking out more of the structure soon, because, as I said, this is just pretty much a wall slash door entranceway. Holy smokes, we have a lot to go. I still got to finish the blooming windows, but to be honest, I'm not putting in the other side until we start marking out the diamonds. The semi-diamond that's meant to be in the center here, because we might have to bring the windows down or make them fatter or skinnier. I don't know at this point. I'm just concerned, so I decided to stop on the windows, and we'll pick that up later on once we've got the diamond logo sort of in place. And yeah, we could pick that up later. I'm not 100% concerned at this time. On the windows. I just really wanted to show you what the 3D windows or the pop-out feel is, the depth feel of the structure is going to be. Okay, guys, thanks for watching episode 5 of Minecraft Down Under. Don't forget, if you liked this video, leave a like, guys, and if you liked it even more, don't forget to share it around to all your friends. All right, guys, you have a good one. Bye!